Good Morning Maine.
Today on Good Morning Maine, the latest on Hurricane Milton as it regains strength and is taking aim at Florida.
Plus, papermakers in Skowhegan gather in a show of solidarity after contract talks led to calls for a strike.
And Acadia National Park unveils new employee housing that will help fill a shortage on MDI. Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith.
And I'm Craig Coulson. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll have those stories and a lot more coming up. But first, we're going to start with a hurricane. That's what's on everyone's mind. Really is a monster storm at this time. It has regained strength to a Category 5 hurricane as it heads towards Florida. Expected to arrive there sometime late tonight or early tomorrow morning. We'll have more on how people are preparing on that. Before that, but first we're going to check in with Devin for our forecast.
I know people are being urged to leave, but time is definitely running out. If they're still there, they may still be stuck.
Yeah.
So here's Devin Biggs with the forecast.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Wednesday, your first weather forecast brought to you by Comfort Shoes and More. Comfort Shoes can help you find the perfect fit for your new fall and winter footwear. Visit us across from Irving and Newport. Alrighty, here we go. A frost advisory up for a few areas this morning, including Bangor. This will last until 8 a.m. this morning. We also have some advisories further off towards the west for frost as well. Meanwhile, though, for the time being, nothing too ridiculous. We are watching a few rain showers that will be moving in as the day gets going. Notice we're seeing those now with clouds from the west going toward the east. Just a few rain showers will be common on and off today. Won't be a big deal at all. We'll even get some sunshine peeking out from time to time. But otherwise, just a few scattered showers being noted across some parts of the northeast. But otherwise, looking rather quiet across a good part of the U.S. at this time. The obvious exception is Florida. Obviously, a few showers on the way for us today. We have a little bit more on the way tonight and maybe a little bit more as we head towards the daytime period tomorrow. As for the winds, roughly at about 5 to 10 miles per hour today, maybe a few higher gusts at times. More wind will be possible tomorrow with gusts that can reach up to around 20 miles per hour at times. So your forecast for today, we have upper 50s partly cloudy with a few rain showers possible. Northwest wind getting up to around 5 miles per hour. The hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period showing some scattered rain showers possible with temperatures warming into the 50s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up.
Thank you, Devin. We'll get another look at that forecast a little later on. Well, first thing this morning, Hurricane Milton is barreling towards Florida as a powerful storm in the Gulf of Mexico. Right now, it's a Category 5, expected to weaken to a 3 or a 4 when it makes landfall later tonight, but still expected to cause major devastation. The biggest concerns are high winds and potentially record-breaking storm surge. The evacuation window quickly closing as the storm moves in. ABC's Raina Roy has the latest from Tampa.
This morning, time is running out to prepare for historic Hurricane Milton as the monster storm closes in on Florida.
This is destructive, life-threatening storm surge, not a safe environment to stay in. So if you're in one of those storm surge evacuation zones along the west coast of Florida, please heed that evacuation advice.
Milton expected to make landfall late tonight as a Category 3 or 4 hurricane, bringing up to 18 inches of rain and a record storm surge of up to 15 feet in the Tampa Bay area. It has the potential to be one of the most destructive hurricanes on record for the state of Florida.
Sarasota County has issued an evacuation for your area.
Authorities driving through coastal neighborhoods warning people to leave while they still can, and if not, prepare for the worst.
Write your name on your arm so we can identify you. We're all talking the same way. Get out of these areas because we can replace your home. We can't replace your life.
Airlines added thousands of seats, allowing more people to get out.
The rain and the wind and all that, and I said, I have to go.
Hurricane hunters flying directly into Milton to gather data, their plane jerking around in extreme turbulence. The governor says the National Guard storm mobilization is likely the largest in state history, with thousands of troops activated. 34 search and rescue planes are on standby, and 37,000 linemen are either in Florida or on the way to help with power outages. One major concern, coastal areas still filled with piles of debris from Hurricane Helene, despite frantic cleanup efforts in recent days. In some areas, a desperate struggle to find gas. More than 30% of gas stations have already run dry in the Fort Myers, Naples area.
It's been a tremendous task to get gas.
And some areas, including Charlotte County, south of Tampa, are now extending evacuation orders further inland because of storm surge concerns. Raina Roy, ABC News, Tampa, Florida.
Well, Mainers are also stepping up to help support communities in Florida ahead of Hurricane Milton's landfall. According to the American Red Cross, two of their volunteers left the Bangor International Airport yesterday morning to help support their operations in response to both the Hurricane Helene and to prepare for Hurricane Milton's arrival. One of those volunteers was John Lee, a clinical director for St. Joseph's Hospital's Emergency Department. Lee says this is his first deployment as a volunteer for the Red Cross.
I just want to be able to help one person. If I can help one person at the end of the day, that makes all the difference.
Well, during his two-week deployment, Lee says he'll be working on the Red Cross's mass sheltering and feeding campaign.
The Red Cross of Northern and Eastern Maine says due to mass cancellations elsewhere in the country for blood drives, it's now even more crucial that Mainers step up to bridge the gap and donate blood. Hundreds of blood drives have been canceled following Hurricane Helene and in anticipation of Hurricane Milton. But that's not the case up here in Maine. According to Executive Director Caroline King, the American Red Cross is urging folks who are healthy and well to donate blood. She says through their national distribution system, donations can be sent to where they're needed most.
Can't make or manufacture blood, it has to come from a volunteer who's giving of their time and of their blood, and we need that desperately right now.
To learn more, visit redcrossblood.org.
Well, in other news this morning, an Augusta man has been indicted on charges following an attempted sexual assault on the Kennebec River Trail. Authorities say it was on July 1st when 57-year-old James Oliver pushed a woman into some brush and told her he was going to rape her. They say a pedestrian interrupted the assault and came to the woman's aid. According to the Morning Sentinel, Oliver has been indicted on charges of attempted gross sexual assault, unlawful sexual contact, and criminal threatening. Described as a transient, Oliver was also convicted of gross sexual assault in 2015 and unlawful sexual contact in 2011. He's also facing burglary and theft charges for an unrelated case involving a theft at a local market.
According to Dover Foxcroft Police Department, they've received several complaints regarding the removal of political signs from public easements in their town. Our Doug Banks explains.
As the days separating now and November 5th begin to lessen, more and more signs of various political candidates begin to appear in abundance. But over this past weekend, the Dover Foxcroft Police Department says they received several complaints regarding the removal of political signs from public easements, specifically along West Main Street and Park Street. In a post on the department's Facebook page, it says, quote, "It was requested that no action be taken, but we are asked to remind folks that tampering with or removal of political signs from any public way or private property is a violation of Maine law. That Maine law is in reference to unlawful removal of temporary signs. Unless a person is authorized to remove signs placed within a public right-of-way, the Maine legislature says a person who takes, defaces, or disturbs a sign placed within the public right-of-way is committing a civil violation. Those found guilty of committing said violation may be adjudged a fine of up to $250. Angel Braggin, a Dover Foxcroft resident and owner of the Store and More, says over this past weekend, she placed a total of six political signs that support former President Donald Trump out on the public easement in front of the Piscataquis County Democrats building on West Main Street. By Monday, those signs were removed, and Braggin says she found them placed behind the building. We reached out to the Piscataquis County Democrats, but did not receive a response.
How much is a sign going to sway somebody? So we all put them out, and it's for a short time. What's the point in not being tolerant?
In Dover Foxcroft, Doug Banks, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Well, in other news, United Steelworkers 4-9 union members voted on September 20th to authorize a strike at the Sappy Mill in Skowhegan. As our Augusta reporter Corey Bouchard reports, while there was no official strike, they did gather yesterday in a show of solidarity as those contract talks continue.
Solidarity was the message here at the Union Hall for United Steelworkers 4-9, who on September 20th voted to authorize a strike for Tuesday, October 8th. Now, union members didn't officially go on strike, but they did hold what they called a solidarity rally in hopes to get the attention of SAPI leadership at the bargaining table for their new contracts. Union members say they have been pushed to the limit with forced overtime that is impacting their health and safety, as well as their ability to see their families. They go on to claim they've had members working mandatory 24-hour shifts with only one day off every 2 weeks, which can lead to an overall public safety issue with operating machinery. Justin Shaw, the union president, says he hopes that this threat of a strike will call on the company to come back to the table with a better offer.
We make a decent living in there. We have decent benefits, but my members do not live to work. They work to live, right? So when you don't have family time, you don't have your holidays, you don't have your weekends, your family's headed to a birthday party or out to camp for the day, and you're headed into the mill to make them more and more money. Sometimes money isn't the deciding factor. Sometimes there's other things. So right now it's a work-life balance that we're really struggling with, and that may be a tipping point.
Forced overtime is a big problem in the paper industry here in Maine. I will say the 24-hour shifts is pretty unique to this location.
A manager for SAPI issued the following statement regarding the strike, quote, "We have presented a highly competitive offer featuring industry-leading wage increases on top of wages that are already among the best in both the industry and the region. We take exception to the union's characterization of the issues regarding overtime and vacation benefits. We remain hopeful that we will reach an agreement," end quote. And we'll continue to follow this story and bring you the latest information as it becomes available. In Skowhegan, I'm Corey Bouchard for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
All right, the time now is 6:11. Coming up next on Good Morning Maine, school is out at the Mountain Valley Middle School, and students will be switching to remote learning as they deal with the latest school closure in Maine.
We'll tell you what's causing it coming up. First, another check of that weather forecast. Today, it looks like a cloudy day ahead. We could see some showers, too, with highs near 59 degrees. Mostly cloudy with a few showers overnight, lows dropping down to the upper 30s. Tomorrow, more of the same, scattered showers on the way for Thursday with highs near 57. We'll be right back.
When R&K Variety in Hamden wants to know the local forecast, they log on to foxbangor.com. R&K Variety is more than just a convenience store, offering fresh cooked meals that don't break the bank, gasoline for your mean machines, or beer and wine so your night is fine. Stop by today.
On at Trurgy Family Orchards. Now is the time to make fall memories. Experience agriculture on a Maine family farm. Open 6 days a week.
Harris Lumber is locally owned and has been serving the Pecos region for more than 50 years. See them for all your projects, big or small. Customer service is their number one priority. And with a full line of lumber and hardware items, they can also deliver to your job site. Harris Lumber, Milo.
It's Judge Judy's greatest hits with classics like
"That's ridiculous.
That's a lot of baloney."
Judge Judy on ABC 7. Jeopardy is for everybody.
That's amazing.
With players just like you.
Paramedic, retired teacher, psychiatrist.
The next super champion could be anyone. It could be you.
Oh, wow.
On Jeopardy.
This week at 7:30, only on ABC 7.
Another Maine school is abruptly closing its doors because it isn't safe for students. Mold problems at Mountain Valley Middle School in Rumford arose earlier this year. Now the superintendent says engineers testing the air in the school say it isn't safe to breathe. Classes are now canceled for the rest of the week, and the building is closed to students until Friday, when they'll be allowed to get their personal property from the school. Students will then begin remote learning next Tuesday, October 15th. School administrators say they are, quote, brainstorming what to do for the rest of the school year. A new school is being built in the area right now, but it won't be ready for at least another year.
Friends of Acadia and Acadia National Park have reached what they say is a major milestone towards addressing staffing and housing shortages as they unveiled new seasonal workforce housing units. Our Grace Blanchard shares more.
We're doing more today for employee housing in Acadia National Park than has been done since the 1960s.
Park officials are calling it a momentous day for Acadia National Park and Friends of Acadia as they showcase their brand new seasonal workforce housing units. In recent years, housing availability has been identified as a critical obstacle for obtaining seasonal employees in the park.
Anything you love in this park was being threatened by the inability to hire the up to 175 seasonal staff that are needed to operate the park.
Two housing units have been built on Dane Farm in Acadia, which will provide a total of 8 beds for their seasonal workforce starting next spring.
So by adding units to the national park, we're trying to own our portion of the solution and hopefully alleviate some of the pressure, if you will, in the greater surrounding MDI Ellsworth location.
Maine Senator Angus King has been a prominent supporter of the project.
It's a milestone for everyone in the area to be able to see what can actually be accomplished. And so it's not disruptive. These are very good-looking, fitting into the neighborhood kinds of projects, and I think it's going to make a big difference here on the island.
Their efforts do not stop here. According to park officials, they are also working to construct 28 new bedrooms for employee housing in Bar Harbor.
Our workforce is critical to be able to welcome 4 million visits a year to Acadia National Park, and so these housing units are going to be on the landscape, serving employees, serving visitors for the next 100 years.
To learn more, visit our website, foxbangor.com. In Seal Harbor, Grace Blanchard, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Well, does your family know what to do in the event of a fire or how to help prevent one? Firefighters went to the Brewer Community School to teach students about just that. Their efforts are a part of the National Fire Prevention Week, a time when those in the firefighting sector highlight issues surrounding safety and focus on education. Brewer Deputy Fire Chief Eric Turtelot says, in addition to planning and prevention, it's just as important to get kids comfortable with the firefighters themselves so they're less scared if a real emergency ever happens.
We want to make sure they're not afraid. We don't want kids running away or hiding from firefighters. And if they're in trouble, seek out firefighter or police officers. You know, that we're here to help.
Well, the students got the chance to check out the fire truck and the firefighters putting on their gear as well. They also got to ask questions now, which Turtelot says can help calm fears when seconds count later on in the event of an emergency. So very important to start young and teach them that. I've heard in the past that the kids will go home and talk to their parents about it, maybe teach their parents a few things, and that just makes everybody that much more safe.
Yeah, those programs, I think the police do them sometimes too, and they're very helpful.
Yeah.
All right, the time now is 6:17. After the break, the whales are back in town in Bar Harbor, with people seeing an exceptional amount of them in the water this year.
We'll take you there as Good Morning Maine continues.
When you're ready to tackle your next building project, depend on the knowledge and experience of Hammond Lumber Company. Hammond's Home Planning Center will turn your ideas into accurate conceptual drawings, and 3D visualization is available. Your Hammond sales rep will prepare a materials list and cost estimate. And when you buy all of your materials from them, Hammond will refund all of your design fees. Hammond can deliver your order from any of their 22 locations across Maine and New Hampshire. Hammond Lumber Company, your building project partner since 1953.
The case against Sean Combs might as well just be called the Freak-Offs.
What prosecutors described as orgies.
Now, as he faces 120 new sexual assault allegations, new reporting, Inside the Secret Life of Diddy, tonight on ABC.
Backed by popular demand, the Lucerne Inn in Dedham presents its amazing Sunday brunch. Join us every Sunday from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. for a culinary experience like no other. Indulge in an exquisite selection of dishes, all while enjoying breathtaking views. Seating is limited, so reservations are recommended, but walk-ins are always welcome. The Lucerne Inn Sunday Brunch, where great food meets a spectacular view. Call today to reserve your spot.
Daler Events and Equipment Rental in Bangor for all your wedding and events. Tents, tables, chairs, and more. Also, see us for your home project equipment rentals. Taylor Events and Equipment Rental, 1179 Hammond Street in Bangor.
Hey.
stated that over 3 million people visit Bar Harbor every year, and this year was no different, but there were a few visitors off the coast that were especially welcomed, albeit a little unexpected.
Our Devin Dagnall explains.
This past year has been exceptionally exciting for whale watching in Maine.
This past few weeks, we've been having upwards of 10 humpbacks, handfuls of fin whales, and even a critically endangered species like the North Atlantic right whale.
That's Abigail Sims, one of the naturalists at Bar Harbor Whale Watching, an organization that works with local experts to take people off the coast of Maine to, you guessed it, watch whales. Abigail says the 2024 season has seen dozens of whales with an excursion success rate of upwards of 95%, compared over the past 3 years where success floated around 90 and 95%. That's on top of the fact that when these boats go out, they're also seeing more whales per trip than they have over the past few years. Abigail mentioned before seeing a few of the critically endangered right whales, which is extraordinary because scientists estimate there are only about 350 of them left in the world.
Seeing a right whale is like finding the golden Easter egg out there. It's something really, really rare for us. So things have changed up here quite a bit with our populations.
Experts aren't quite sure what's causing the uptick in activity, but they say there are a few factors that could be coming into play. It could be the currents are just right for the plankton, or it could be cooler temperatures are keeping the whales in the area for longer, or it could just be luck. No matter the reason, Abigail says Bar Harbor Whale Watching expects to see whales through the rest of its season, and you can book a trip through barharborwhales.com.
Getting to come out and learning about these animals, that's a way we can protect them. If you know more about them and you know more about the threats and you can kind of spread the word of like, hey, this is what these whales are facing and this is what we learned we can do to fix it, that can get spread beyond us and we can reach people that otherwise wouldn't get a chance to come out on a trip like this.
In Bar Harbor, Devin Dagnall, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Boy, I've never been on one of those. I need to do it one of these days. I've seen whales out there, but never on like an official whale watching boat.
Yeah, so. I've been on it once. I was just telling Craig while we were watching it. A lot of people get seasick, so bring your Dramamine. It's quite serious.
Yeah.
But we saw a lot of whales. This was years ago. But yeah, it's pretty reliable that you'll see whales.
Great opportunity too.
Yeah.
Get down to the coast.
Nothing
enjoy,
like it.
Enjoy some foliage. All the tourists, but a bunch of them are gone. And
I know. It's pretty crazy being able to look like a 360 view around you and not see land on any side. A lot of us are not used to that.
Well, meanwhile, we're going to turn our attention to the weather once again. As we said at the top of the show, we're watching Hurricane Milton closely. I have been watching Facebook, too. A number of Mainers have been reaching out, and a lot of them are heeding the warnings and getting out of the way. Yeah. I have one local friend who was down there with her family. They went to Disney, and they closed the airport down there. So they decided to rent a car, and now they're getting the heck out of Florida and heading north on I-95. Around here, it looks like calmer weather. It looks like just a chance of rain later on today.
Yep. Let's get a look at that forecast with Devin Biggs.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Wednesday. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Comfort Shoes and More. Comfort Shoes can help you find the perfect fit for your new fall and winter footwear. Visit us across from Irving and Newport. Alrighty, here we go. Frost advisory up until 8 a.m. this morning from Bangor areas further off towards the east. And a few frost advisories off toward the west as well. That's not the only thing we're watching. We're watching for some active surf at times. Notice the wave heights at around 4 to 5 feet according to the buoys. No advisories in effect. Offshore, at least at this moment in time, we'll keep an eye on that. Notice though, the ocean a little bit further active, the ocean though, further out towards sea, a little bit more active at around 7 to 8 feet according to the buoys there. And of course, we have a hurricane near Florida. We'll talk about that in a little bit. On land though, we are seeing a few showers that are developing this morning. There they are, there, tracking from the west going toward the east. So a few showers will be common on and off throughout the daytime period today with sunshine that will also peak out from time to time. Here's the area, a little pressure right about in here. Nothing too ridiculous here with a few showers across the northeastern states. Obviously, very active weather moving into Florida. With Hurricane Milton, as of the last update, this thing is mean. A Category 5 major hurricane tracking off towards the north and east. This thing just looks very impressive as it tracks off towards the north and east, heading right towards Florida. The latest information we have has that around 160 miles per hour with some gusty winds. This is ugly. 200 miles per hour and moving towards the northeast at 12 12 miles per hour, so it's speeding up. Hurricane warnings in the red. Tropical storm warnings also being noted in the orange. And its projected path will take it through parts of Florida throughout the daytime period, coming up even later on tonight into parts of Thursday morning. So tonight into Thursday morning, that's when this thing will begin to move in. And it could make landfall as a Category 3 or 4 hurricane somewhere between Tampa and Fort Myers. So it's going to be very ugly to see how this thing behaves as we do move forward in time. Hopefully everyone that you know of has evacuated from Florida, or at least moved to a spot that won't be as affected as badly from this storm. But meanwhile, though, for today here at home, we'll be partly cloudy with highs in the upper 50s. A few rain showers possible, no big deal there. Northwest wind getting up to around 5 miles per hour. Later on tonight, upper 30s, mostly cloudy. A few rain showers possible again. West wind getting up to around 5 miles per hour. Tomorrow, upper 50s, partly cloudy. Some scattered rain showers possible. More so sprinkles with that northwest wind getting up to around 25 miles per hour. All righty, let's check out your extended forecast brought to you by Comfort Shoes and More. Partly cloudy Friday with highs in the low 60s. Lower 60s again for a Saturday with a chance for rain showers. And partly cloudy Sunday with highs in the upper 50s.
I've been on the water since I was 2 days old. Fished up and down the coast from Nantucket to Eastport. I've been paying into Medicare, Social Security, my whole life, every paycheck. Those benefits should be there when we retire. But Austin Terrier wants to join extremists in Congress, trying to cut Social Security and Medicare. I earned those benefits. Austin Terrier should not be able to take those away.
DCCC is responsible for the content of this ad.
Fall into amazing savings during Flex Deals Fall Factory Authorized Sale. Rake in serious deals on all styles and models. Choose from our huge selection of fabric and leather, reclining and stationary furniture, including Flex Deals Latitude, South Haven, and Wynwood collections, and all crafted with Flex Deals exclusive lifetime warranted Blue Seal Spring. Prices are falling, so hurry in today for cool savings. Fall in love at Flex Deals Factory Authorized Sale.
Dorsey Furniture, Route 1A Holden. Live beautifully, my friends.
As temperatures drop, fall colors emerge. Reds, yellows, and of course, Kubota Orange. Forget the greens and make your neighbors orange with envy with a new Kubota tractor from Doors Equipment in Bangor. Get your work done right with Kubota and Doors. From home to farm, from landscaping to construction, the Doors are open to value, quality, and top-notch service. This fall, make them orange with envy at Doors Equipment, Outer Hammond Street, Bangor.
It's another exciting year of high school football in the state of Maine. Get out and support your home team and be looking for the ABC7 Sports Blitz crew. You can get a free Sports Blitz t-shirt, then watch Sports Blitz during ABC7 News at 11 every Friday night during the football season. Blitz shirts courtesy of
Bears Den, Foxcroft Academy, Johnson Foundations, Kelly Jost State Farm Insurance Agent, Mallet Real Estate Agency, McCusick Petroleum Company, Moosehead Trail Home and Heart, Rowell's Garage and Car Wash.
You're watching ABC7 Bangor.
Welcome back, everyone. This morning, we're hearing reactions on the new allegations about former President Trump's relationship with Vladimir Putin, including the claim that he sent the Russian president COVID tests during the height of the pandemic. It comes as the race for the White House continues to tighten. Here's ABC's Christiane Cordero from Washington.
Today, as the storm-ravaged southeastern states brace for a major hurricane while recovering from another, the battle on the campaign trail is over the government's response. President Biden blasting former President Trump for spreading disinformation about FEMA, which has been on the ground for days.
I'll use an old phrase, it's un-American. It really is. People are scared to death.
And in new controversies, journalist Bob Woodward's upcoming book, War, reports Trump secretly sent rare COVID tests to Russia for Vladimir Putin's personal use during the height of the pandemic. Vice President Harris, speaking with Stephen Colbert overnight, slammed Trump.
You remember how many people did not have tests? And this man is giving COVID test kits to Vladimir Putin?
Woodward also reports Trump had, quote, multiple phone calls with Putin since leaving the White House, including at least one call earlier this year. In a phone call with ABC's Jonathan Carl, Trump denies everything.
So you haven't spoken to him since you left the White House?
No, I have not.
And the other thing he said is that you had provided some Abbott test machines to Putin back during the COVID pandemic.
Yeah, false.
Trump's most recent attack against Harris is centered around comments she made on The View, saying she wouldn't have done many things differently than President Biden.
Every time she does an interview, she sounds like a child.
Harris has spent the week on a media blitz, criticizing Trump for not doing the same, instead inviting voters to watch his rallies and consider that his pitch.
What he does not talk about is you. He does not talk about what you need. He does not talk about what your parents need, what your children need. He talks about his needs.
Trump rallies today in Pennsylvania. Harris travels to Las Vegas ahead of an event there tomorrow. Christiane Cordero, ABC News, Washington.
11 members of the same family were killed when Hurricane Helene devastated the community named for them. Diane Wilson has more from Fairview, North Carolina.
It's unrecognizable now, but this is where I was born and raised.
This is what's left of Craigtown. Now Jesse Craig is trying to pick up the pieces, grappling with the incredible loss of losing 11 of his family members.
My mother and father, my aunt and uncle, my great aunt and uncle, lost cousins, second cousins, things like that. But 11 people overall from this mudslide.
Massive mudslides. You can see the path of destruction. Several homes just gone.
There was one up here, a brick house, and then my parents' house, a building. There were buildings through here.
All of these homes, his family's proud history, now piles of rubble. As Jesse walked Eyewitness News around his family land, he shared how his grandfather bought this land more than 80 years ago.
The locals call it Craigtown because I'm a Craig, and a lot of my family still live over there. My dad was born and raised there. You know, my whole family's been in this tight-knit community.
The family built 8 decades of memories, but never could imagine suffering a loss like this. Included in the 11 family members of firefighter Tony Garrison, who died while saving a family member from this home. Look at this red truck. One of Jesse's family survived the onslaught inside of it when the mudslides came, carrying his truck to here. Then he had to break the back window to escape.
We'll never make sense of it. You know, it's our community and our town. I don't know that it'll ever be the same.
Since Helene, Jesse and his wife surrounded by family, friends, and the entire Fairview community, along with total strangers, helping Craigtown, an online fundraiser raising more than $50,000 to help pay for the 11 funerals, medical expenses of those family still in the hospital, and to one day rebuild Craigtown.
We don't want people to forget, like, months down the road. Like, this isn't just a week or two fix. This is,
we gotta be in it for the long haul. This is gonna take, you know, years of work, repair, try to have it recognizable again.
Unimaginable for most of us to realize what they're going through down there. Unfortunately, it looks like more people are about to go through it themselves.
I know. Yeah. I know these people are still kind of, a lot of folks are still without housing, still without their earthly possessions. Yeah. So, yeah. All right. Right after the break, coming up on the second half of the newscast, the race is on at a Herman school to see which class can donate the most socks to the local area homeless shelters.
We'll tell you all about it as Good Morning Maine continues.
I'm Jared Golden, and I approve this message.
Big drug companies were ripping off diabetics like me. Jared Golden knew that was wrong, and he voted to cap insulin at $35 a month for seniors. Not Austin Terrio. He said the bill Jared supported wouldn't help everyday middle-class people like me. Terrio isn't even in Congress yet, and he's already out of touch and is on the record opposing benefits for seniors on Medicare. We can't afford Austin Terrio.
Maine's largest network of parts just got a little bigger. Coastal Auto Parts, newest location in Bangor, has all your automotive needs to get you to the moments that matter most. Whether you're a professional mechanic or just need a little help, find everything you need all under one roof. Our knowledgeable staff is here to assist you with friendly service and expert advice right here at 200 Sylvan Road, just off I-95. Drive in, stock up, and hit the road with confidence. Coastal Auto Parts is owned and operated by a Maine family that cares.
Join us every Friday this season as we celebrate the return to the gridiron with the most highlights, reactions, and analysis of your favorite teams. Catch Sports Blitz Friday at 11 on ABC7. Sports Blitz is brought to you by Coastal Auto Parts, your local Napa Auto Parts dealer with 30 locations, owned and operated by a Maine family that cares. And by Dorsey Furniture, Route 1A Holden, where you'll find furniture that's in stock and ready for delivery.
Roto-Rooter has served the greater Bangor area and beyond for 35 years, offering plumbing, hydrojetting, snaking, descaling, video inspection, and grease interceptor cleaning services. For all your residential and commercial clogs, call Roto-Rooter today, 990-1234.
And away go troubles down the drain, Roto-Rooter.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Everyone, today is Wednesday, October 9th, and today is also National Pizza and Beer Day. Two very good things.
Pizza and a beer day.
And a beer, okay.
Yeah, so it's meant to go together.
Okay.
What more do we have to say, though? I mean, today is a simple holiday that says indulge in a treat if you like. And if that's not for you, well, it's also National Curious Events Day.
Hmm.
A day intended for us to get lost in thought about things we can't find any answers to personally. I'll celebrate both at the same time.
Yeah, it's just like Sasquatch kind of stuff, or just...
I guess so.
Just the, whatever you're curious about,
if that's
about,
what
huh?
you find yourself thinking about when you're alone and lost in thought.
Sometimes I'm thinking about the Sasquatch.
Sasquatch?
Not really.
I've never heard it pronounced that way.
Really?
What Sasquatch?
Sasquatch, Sasquatch. Yeah. Yeah, Bigfoot.
Sasquatch, lost that? In the sauce.
Yeah. Sounds like a great big dessert, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be a good, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Sasquatch.
Any chefs out there, I advise you now.
That'd be great.
It's your next dessert special.
All right, let's get to some history. It was on this day in history back in 1635, Roger Williams was banished from the Massachusetts Bay Colony for preaching about things like religious freedom and spiritual equality. And as a result, he later founded the Colony of Rhode Island. They've got a park named after him there now.
They're very proud of him there.
Yeah.
Yep.
In 1888, the Washington Monument in Washington, D.C., a marble-faced granite obelisk, opened up to the public. Took a long time to build it. Mm-hmm. They did it in stages, too, as I recall.
Mm-hmm.
1936, the Boulder Dam, later called the Hoover Dam, on the Arizona-Nevada border, began generating electricity. And in 1941, Franklin Delano Roosevelt approved an atomic program that would become the Manhattan Project.
In 1992, a meteorite crashed through a red Chevy Malibu in Peekskill, New York. It reportedly was the size of a bowling ball, was warm to the touch, and smelled vaguely of rotten eggs. That's a photo of the Chevy right there.
Yeah.
And in 2012, women's rights and education activist Malala Yousafzai was shot 3 times by a Taliban gunman as she tried to board her school bus in northwest Pakistan. And last year, in 2023, the world record was set for the heaviest pumpkin. A jack-o'-lantern weighing 2,749 pounds, grown in Minnesota, which would be enough for 687 pies.
That's a lot of pies. Mm-hmm. Those guys that do the big pumpkins, they take it pretty serious,
I
too.
I love those. Yeah. I've always wanted to go to one of those agricultural fairs where they have, like, the pumpkin, like, chucking, too,
with
the, you know, what are those called?
Catapults.
Catapults, right.
They also do, they carve them out and they use them as boats sometimes.
Yeah.
So this place down in, I think down in Wisconsin or something like that. So I'd
love
to
fun.
Try that.
Mm-hmm.
All right, for birthdays today, we have actor Tony Shalhoub. Shalhoub?
Yeah, I think that's how you pronounce it.
I know who he is.
I love the show Monk, so.
Yeah, he's 71 years old today. Mexican filmmaker and author Guillermo del Toro is 60.
Guillermo.
You're so much better on those names than I am.
Mm.
And TV personality Sharon Osbourne.
Osbourne.
I know I did that on purpose.
Oh,
I know
my
who she
gosh.
Is. Sharon Osbourne is 72 years old today. Ozzy!
I love that show.
I watched the Osbournes
a little
bit. They're
so ridiculous. You're the beer thief. Did you ever see that episode?
No,
he comes out, he's like, who drank all my beer?
It's because he's
brain damaged.
just a little bit. A little bit. Poor old Ozzy.
I love them so much.
Hey, turning our attention back to the weather around here. We've been talking about the hurricane around here, though. It's going to be quieter. You can prepare for maybe a few showers today.
Mm-hmm. Here's Devin Biggs with the forecast.
All righty, thank you very much. Happy Wednesday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Comfort Shoes and More. Comfort Shoes can help you find the perfect fit for your new fall and winter footwear. Visit us across from Irving and Newport. All righty, here we go. A frost advisory up for a few areas this morning, including Bangor. This will last until 8 a.m. this morning. We also have some advisories further off towards the west for frost as well. Meanwhile, though, for the time being, nothing too ridiculous. We are watching a few rain showers that will be moving in as the day gets going. Notice we're seeing those now with clouds from the west going toward the east. Just a few rain showers will be common on and off today. It won't be a big deal at all. We'll even get some sunshine peeking out from time to time. But otherwise, just a few scattered showers being noted across some parts of the northeast. But otherwise, looking rather quiet across a good part of the U.S. at this time. The obvious exception is Florida. Obviously, a few showers on the way for us today. We have a little bit more on the way tonight and maybe a little bit more as we head towards the daytime period tomorrow. As for the winds, roughly at about 5 to 10 miles per hour today, maybe a few higher gusts at times. More wind will be possible tomorrow with gusts that can reach up to around 20 miles per hour at times. So your forecast for today, we have upper 50s partly cloudy with a few rain showers possible. Northwest wind getting up to around 5 miles per hour. The hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period showing some scattered rain showers possible with temperatures warming into the 50s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up.
Thank you, Devin. Well, middle school students in Herman are collecting socks for those in need. For the entire month, all students in 5th through 8th grade are collecting new socks as part of Socktober. The donations are collected in boxes in each homeroom, and the classroom that collects the largest amount will win a pizza party, courtesy of the school's student council.
I just hope they learn that, you know, doing things for others is a great thing and it's rewarding. Whether you get the pizza party or not, you're doing something for those in need, and that always feels good.
The school has set a goal to collect 1,000 or more pairs of socks for the homeless. It's still early in the month, so the students have plenty of time to bring in their donations to meet their goal.
Good for them. They always say that's like one of the biggest things that they're looking for as far as donations go. Mm-hmm. So they'll be helping a lot of people this winter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, right after the break, Tyler Cruz will have the latest with sports.
Don't go away.
Why should your new floor come from Carpet One? Because we're passionate about the spaces our neighbors call home. We're part of your community, and we're also part of the world's largest cooperative of independently owned and operated flooring stores. So you can be sure you'll get great selection and outstanding value with every installation. Whether it's carpet, hardwood, tile, or luxury vinyl, our experts take the guesswork out of choosing the right floor. We're your local Carpet One Floor and Home, the one store for your perfect floor.
I got hurt by a big truck. Why did I call the twos?
Because life-changing injuries deserve life-changing money, and I'll fight to get it for you. We got a client who broke multiple bones in a commercial vehicle accident, $700,000. Another client had a brain injury, and we got them $1.15 million.
If you get hurt by a big truck, call the twos.
We win for you.
Hurt by a big truck? Call the twos. We win for you.
It's another exciting year of high school football in the state of Maine. Get out and support your home team and be looking for the ABC7 Sports Blitz crew. You can get a free Sports Blitz t-shirt, then watch Sports Blitz during ABC7 News at 11 every Friday night during the football season. Blitz shirts courtesy of
Detail 207, The Family Dog, Katahdin Trust Company, Kylie Bean Insurance Agency, The Local, Orono Trampoline Park, and Rose Bicycle.
Plan and build your ideal new home or garage with a customized building package from Hammond Lumber Company, your building project partner.
The time has finally come. Welcome back in, everyone. Thank you for staying with us. When the New England Patriots take the field at Gillette Stadium Sunday against the Houston Texans, Drake May will be under center for his first career start. It was first reported on Tuesday morning by Adam Schefter. The Patriots selected May with the third overall pick, and he excelled in the preseason. Jacoby Brissett this season has thrown for 697 yards in 5 weeks with just two touchdowns and one interception and a 74.2 passer rating. And the offense is averaging 12.4 points per game, the last in the league. We will hear from Gerard Mayo and the team on Wednesday about the decision. Let's head over to Orono now to check in with Maine Hockey, who picked up their first win of the year on Saturday behind a huge night from their third line. Jack Webb has the story.
I think we can be one of the strongest and heaviest lines in college hockey, so we got to stick to that identity.
Maine men's hockey opened their season in dominant fashion on Saturday, cruising to a 6-0 win over AIC.
The depth of the team showed, and I think there's a lot to grow from that game. And for the first game, I think it's a good starting point.
Maine's third line of Nolan Renwick, Taylor McCarr, and Ross Mitten were at the forefront of the Black Bear attack as their line combined for 10 total points.
Those are two really easy guys to play with. They play the right way. They play a hard and heavy style of hockey, so I think we mesh real well together from the start.
Renwick led the way with 2 goals and 2 assists, recording over a third of his point total from last season in just one night.
Put in a lot of work during the summer to, have a good start and to contribute a little bit more to the team this year, and just to see that come to fruition in the first game, it meant a lot to see the hard work pay off.
As for McCarr, he tallied 2 goals and 1 assist during his debut as he loudly introduced himself to Black Bear Nation, scoring on his first shift in a Maine jersey.
I was so proud to go out there, and, the crowd is always amazing. I got chills when I was hearing everyone chant at the starting lineups, and getting a first win for these fans, and they give so much to us, so it's great to give back.
Ross Mitten added 3 assists, rounding out a huge night for Maine's third line. Renwick, Mitten, and McCarr weigh a combined 625 pounds, making them one of the heaviest forward lines in college hockey. And they know they have to use all of it.
I think that's part of our job, getting some energy for the team and trying to get those heavy shifts on the opponents. So I think that's important for our line, and we know that role.
Coach Barr says the challenge for this group will be consistency.
When they're moving their feet, it's really hard to defend a line like that. And you saw that in that game, and the challenge will be, can you do that every weekend?
From Orono, Jack Webb, ABC 7, Fox 22 Sports.
Thanks for that, Jack. Certainly a big weekend at the Alphon. Let's go to some high school soccer now in a big Class B North girls matchup over at Pottle Field. John Bapps, the home team in this one, hosting the Eagles from Ellsworth. No score in the first half when we pick it up. Quinn Bennett sends it in for Jackie Pangburn. This one is going to get through the defense. She gets into the box, fires with the left, and scores. That makes it 1-0, John Bapps. Here's Ellsworth looking to answer. A great ball here from Lizzie Bowles is going to find Cameron Clough. She fires. She gets a great look. But look at Grace Bouchard with the leaping save to keep the Eagles at bay. Still in the first, Bapps gets a great chance here. But Sage Gokul in net comes away with the save in traffic to keep it 1-0. To the second half now, direct kick for the Crusaders. And Quinn Bennett blasts this one. She scores up top, and the Crusaders win 2-0. Over to the Weatherby Complex now. Brewer boys traveling to take on Hamden Academy. Game tied at 1. We're picking it up in the first half, which is with it. Nick Godfrey turns on the Jets and then muscles into the box, fires a shot, and this one is just going to miss high. Great chance there for Brewer. Moving on to the second half now. Hamden has it. Really good ball from Lucas Facciol. He finds Aiden Ball, who chases it down in the corner and fires, but Eli Willett dives and comes up with the save for the Witches. Which is on the throw-in now in the second half. Charlie Bridges times it perfectly, gets ahead on it. It takes a scary bounce if you're a Bronco, but that strong defense gets it out of there, and that defense would hold the Witches at bay. Hamden wins 3-1. And in golf, the KVAC qualifiers Tuesday at Natanis Golf Course. These are the team results from Class A. Brewer, Camden Hills, and Bangor each qualify. Brewer wins the tournament. Edward Little qualifies as well after winning the conference. Individually, Will Farshone of Brunswick was the leader at 3 over 75. Eddie Goff of Skowhegan, Jacoby Harvey of Bangor, and Calvin Grass of Brewer each tied for second, 2 strokes off the lead. And in Class B, Lincoln Academy wins. Morse Gardner and Belfast all qualify as teams. Kellen Addix shot a 6-under 66 for the individual title, followed by Jack Quinn of Gardner with a 73, Jade Haylock of Levitt with a 77, and then Austin Gould of Gardner and Caden Nickerson from Belfast. All right, big congratulations to all of them. That is all the time we have for sports. We'll be right back after the break.
Back again, huh? You must love losing.
You're buying the next
You gotta win one first.
Okay.
Get two of your McDonald's favorites like the McDouble or McChicken for $3.99 or mix and match. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
I'm Jared Golden, and I approve this message.
A new law that outlawed abortion passed 6 weeks in all cases.
These laws make me sick and heartbroken.
The government shouldn't be in the examining room.
It's extremists that don't allow women to have choice.
It's none of your business.
Austin Terrio is on the same side as the extremists who want to have a national abortion ban.
And these extremists, they're going to try to control women.
What else will they ban? What else will they monitor? What other privacy will we lose? Austin Terrio scares me.
Motorcycle accidents can happen fast. The effect on your life can be devastating.
I wasn't going to take a chance on my future.
I needed a lawyer who fights for bikers' rights.
Motorcycle law is complicated, and you'll need somebody who knows motorcycle law. A name the insurance companies know all too well.
A lawyer with the power to get you more.
They got me way more than I thought I'd get.
Call Joe. The law offices of Joe Bornstein. Right now.
Tell them you mean business.
Any slow zipper knows you'll enjoy your drink from McDonald's longer than anyone else.
Savor every sip of your favorite any size soft drink for just $1.29. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
The Bangor Historical Society held a ribbon-cutting ceremony yesterday to celebrate the completion of the granite wall and fence restoration at the nonprofit's Hill House headquarters. The project took 106 days from start to finish. The city of Bangor helped fund $60,000 of the restoration through the city's Community Development Block Program. Christine Barr, the president of the Bangor Historical Society, says seeing the work completed is really a dream come true.
It's an important building to the city, the state, and the nation. And we're very proud to have been able to get the restoration to this point.
And this granite work is exceptional, and it was really important to keep that. And the gate, they have been having some security issues, so the gate is important for them to be able to protect the property.
Well, the Bangor Historical Society's next project will be to fix the portico on the Hill House, which is the first building famous architect Richard Upjohn ever created. The Hill House is almost 200 years old and is still standing tall on Union Street here in the city of Bangor. Really is a treasure, too. All right, time for one final look at that forecast with Devin Biggs.
Alrighty, thank you very much. Happy Wednesday. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Comfort Shoes and More. Comfort Shoes can help you find the perfect fit for your new fall and winter footwear. Visit us across from Irving and Newport. Alrighty, here we go. Frost advisory up until 8 a.m. this morning from Bangor areas further off towards the east, and a few frost advisories off toward the west as well. That's not the only thing we're watching. We're watching for some active surf at times. Notice the wave heights at around 4 to 5 feet according to the buoys. No advisories in effect offshore, at least at this moment in time. We'll keep an eye on that. Notice, though, the ocean a little bit further active. The ocean, though, further out towards sea, a little bit more active at around 7 to 8 feet, according to the buoys there. And, of course, we have a hurricane near Florida. We'll talk about that in a little bit. On land, though, we are seeing a few showers that are developing this morning. There they are there, tracking from the west, going toward the east. So a few showers will be common on and off throughout the daytime period today, with sunshine that will also peak out from time to time. Here's the area, a little pressure right about in here. Nothing too ridiculous here with a few showers across the northeastern states. Obviously, very active weather moving into Florida with Hurricane Milton. As of the last update, this thing is mean. A Category 5 major hurricane tracking off towards the north and east. This thing just looks very impressive as it tracks off towards the north and east, heading right towards Florida. The latest information we have has that around 160 miles per hour with some gusty winds. This is ugly. 200 miles per hour and moving towards the northeast at 12 miles per hour, so it's speeding up. Hurricane warnings in the red. Tropical storm warnings also being noted in the orange. This projected path will take it through parts of Florida throughout the daytime period, coming up even later on tonight into parts of Thursday morning. So tonight into Thursday morning, that's when this thing will begin to move in, and it could make landfall as a Category 3 or 4 hurricane somewhere between Tampa and Fort Myers. So it's going to be very ugly to see how this thing behaves as we do move forward in time. Hopefully everyone that you know of has evacuated from Florida, or at least moved move to a spot that won't be as affected as badly from this storm. But meanwhile, though, for today here at home, we'll be partly cloudy with highs in the upper 50s. A few rain showers possible, no big deal there. Northwest wind getting up to around 5 miles per hour. Later on tonight, upper 30s, mostly cloudy. A few rain showers possible again. West wind getting up to around 5 miles per hour. Tomorrow, upper 50s, partly cloudy. Some scattered rain showers possible. More so sprinkles with that northwest wind getting up to around 25 miles per hour. All righty, let's check out your extended forecast brought to you by Comfort Shoes and More. Partly cloudy Friday with highs in the low 60s. Lower 60s again for your Saturday with a chance for rain showers. And partly cloudy Sunday with highs in the upper 50s.
People ask me all the time, are those commercials really true? Does Lowry & Associates really get all of those clients, all of those big settlements? Yes, we do. We really have gotten millions of dollars for Mainers hurt by commercial vehicles. And the insurance companies know when you call the twos, we're going to fight for you. And you know what else is true? I really am standing on top of this big truck.
Hurt by a big truck? Call the twos. We win for you.
Class-leading safety features at every turn. The Hyundai Tucson.
Lease an all-wheel drive Tucson for $229 a month. Or get 1.99% APR or up to $1,250 bonus cash. See your local Bangor Hyundai dealer.
The time to make fall memories. Experience agriculture on a Maine family farm. Open 6 days a week.
Pat's Pizza in Holden is not just a restaurant that serves delicious food and pizza. They also have an adjacent party and event room. Consider having your birthday or office party at Pat's Pizza. They have indoor golf, a pro shop, and a beautiful 9-hole golf course open for the season. Pat's Pizza, Holden.
I am starting to fall for Joan.
There's hope. I can imagine it now. So bad for him.
Get a little of this one. France's Combe Girardeau has leapt to a world record in death diving after a stunning jump off a Spanish cliff on Monday. Death diving, I didn't know it was a thing.
Yeah, it is.
The 22-year-old from Bordeaux made the jump from the 44-meter high cliff of the Simbara waterfall near the town of Aldequamamada. That's not how you pronounce it, but it's close. After descending for about 3 seconds, he dived into the water hands first and feet first at a speed of 106 kilometers per hour. A dozen of his friends and competitors on the DOD's Diving World Tour were there in the water to support him. Death diving.
What?
It's a real thing.
What?
Yeah, they do this and they curl into a fetal position right before they hit so that they don't suffer extreme internal injuries. I was just reading about it. Because okay. if you do a belly flop or something, it could kill you.
It looked like he was about to.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to do some Googling. Yeah. Cool. Okay. Well, it looks like we're running out of time. If you missed anything, head to foxbangor.com.
Have a great day, everyone.
Maine's largest network of parts just got a little bigger. Coastal Auto Parts, newest location in Bangor, has all your automotive needs to get you to the moments that matter most. Whether you're a professional mechanic or just need a little help, find everything you need all under one roof. Our knowledgeable staff is here to assist you with friendly service and expert advice right here at 200 Sylvan Road, just off I-95. Drive in, stock up, and hit the road with confidence. Coastal Auto Parts is owned and operated by a Maine family that cares.
Back by popular demand, the Lucerne Inn in Dedham presents its amazing Sunday brunch. Join us every Sunday from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. for a culinary experience like no other. Indulge in an exquisite selection of dishes, all while enjoying breathtaking views. Seating is limited, so reservations are recommended, but walk-ins are always welcome. The Lucerne Inn Sunday brunch, where great food meets a spectacular view. Call today to reserve your spot.
You're gripping a pumpkin spice latte,
Watching the home game on a Friday night. Earlier, you took the kids apple picking and almost made it through the corn maze. It's that time of year. Shorter days, cooler nights. Valley Home Services believes the comfort and warmth of home means more on nights like these. Comfort and warmth that comes from Fujitsu heat pumps. Valley Home Services has the most reliable choices for heating and cooling your home or business. Ditch the worry of heating bills and power outages all season long with Valley Home Services. Go ahead, embrace the comfort.
Are your basement walls bowing, crumbling, or failing? Hi, I'm Tony Hafford with TC Hafford Basement Systems, all things basement-y. Our stable lock wall system offers a patented, affordable, and permanent solution to save your foundation walls. It stabilizes, fills voids, and structurally repairs, leaving a new, smooth surface. All the strength of new walls. Call TC Hafford Basement Systems today for all things basement-y.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Good morning, America.
And streaming live in HD worldwide at foxbangor.com. More people choose Good Morning News.
Hello, everyone. Today on Good Morning Maine, the latest on Hurricane Milton as it regains strength and is taking aim at Florida.
Plus, papermakers in Skowhegan gather in a show of solidarity after contract talks led to calls for a strike.
And Acadia National Park unveils new employee housing that will help fill a shortage there on MDI.
Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith.
And I'm Craig Colson. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll have those stories and much more coming up. But first, we're going to kick things off with a look at Milton. It's just turned into another monster storm out there. Back to Category 5 strength. You can imagine the feeling for the folks there on the west coast of Florida this morning. It's expected to arrive sometime late tonight or early tomorrow morning, and people are getting the heck out of the way. Good thing they're doing it.